please. It's happened before. Last time we put it down to premarital nerves. What do we call it this time?
Over and turns out the light. Undetected. Or so he thinks.
A sensible girl avoids the slightest romantic involvement of any kind. But as soon as I saw him, I knew I had to have him. There was something very primitive about it, addictive. And the more we kissed, the more I wanted it, the more I needed it.
Don't you just hate it when that happens? You think you've met the perfect one. He seems obliging, pleasant enough. You date, you marry, he promises to love and cherish you forever. And then he goes and shags behind your back.
We have re-entered what his mistress has called the Twilight Zone. Surviving on quickies during lunch, restaurants which have been purposely hidden away from prying wives, and the essential weekends away. Sign here, please, Mr. and Mrs. Smith. Or if Welsh fails, make for the great
outdoors!
Men are programmed to shag loads so as to scatter their sperm and secure the continuation of their genes. Evolution is that? He doesn't even want kids.
I love you.
For fuck's sake, I'm trying to watch telly.
It's me.
Can't talk right now, I'm busy.
Too busy to fuck.
Tonight,
yes.
Doing what?
None of your business.
I could come round.
He started to get demanding, and that is just not allowed to play by the rules.
I need to see you.
You'll see me tomorrow at work. Good night. Big comfy pants. Come on, girl.
are you going?
Other husbands.
I may have to quit work. He's behaving like a complete dick.
I love you. I thought you felt the same way.
Well, you thought wrong. I mean, I'm fond of you, but no, I don't love you.
You fucking bitch.
What? All marriages have their ups and downs. Divorce is hideously expensive. And I really didn't want to leave this house or cancel Mexico.
He's taken to phoning me late at night, leaving crude and threatening messages.
Don't piss me off!
He's becoming obsessional, and that just won't do. I have my other life, my other projects. I think it's time I had word with his wife.
Shoes?
Oh, thanks.
More fool I. He didn't dump her, she dumped him.
She invites me back. Coffee.
Decaf?
And a chat.
A tragic accident.
Dead. With his dick cut off.
The police arrive and find bits of his willy in the vacuum cleaner.
Sorry, love, can I just squeeze through?
By all means.
He had sought sexual satisfaction with it, then bled to death when the machine cut it off. Is that right?
Seems that way.
Cock everywhere.
Silly man. Hadn't realised that there's a blade in the vacuum cleaner.
Right under where the nozzle attaches itself.
The ultimate blowjob.
And all that during half-time.